the fire within at Beacon Ridge Academy. Our school is a college prep school, so we put a high value on academics here. A lot of kids are stressed out about that, so we want to fix it. I'm McKenna. This is Sarah, Grady, Alex, and Josh. To me, social entrepreneurship is the balance between profitable and nonprofit organizations.
We establish a new venture that helps solve social problems and benefit society.
Hi, I'm McKenna. I'm a Red, and I'm involved in drama.
Hi, I'm Irene. I'm also a Red, and I'm involved in athletics.
And together, we have awesome interpersonal skills.
I'm Josh, I'm detailed, and I'm also pursuing law because I'm green.
My name is Alexander, and I'm a blue, which means I'm very analytical. I'm also the president of student council.
Behind the camera, we have...
Hi, I'm Sarah Stewart, I'm a yellow, creative, and I'm also going to film school.
All the members of our class brought in their unique talents when working on this project. Some were very detail-orientated, while others brought in creative ideas. When all of these qualities were brought together, it allowed amazing outcomes to happen. We are led by instructor Jen Marshall, and we are such a small group, we can hold each other accountable. This is why our team is awesome.
Suicidal people often believe that they can't be helped, so it's important to let them know that they're not alone. When you see someone showing suicidal signs, such as disinterest, direct or indirect verbal cues, behavioral cues, and situational cues, remember QPR. QPR stands for question, persuade, and refer. Asking someone if they are suicidal is a delicate process. Remember to be gentle and not so direct, then persuade them to let you help them through counselors or therapists. Then you can refer them to outside help. Suicide is a dangerous issue, so don't hesitate to get involved or take the lead.
Hi, I'm Alex, and because I was a blue, I'm in charge of our needs assessment for this Fire Within program. Each one of us were in charge of separate pieces of the needs assessment. I was specifically in charge of finding facts about our high school. Some of those facts include our GPA, dropout rate, and free and reduced lunch, how many people would be on that. We're fairly average in every sense. Our dropout rate is significantly lower than other high schools. Our free and reduced lunch program is about the same as most schools. And our GPA is also fairly average. So from mine, the needs assessment tests were very inconclusive. From Irene, she did our observational assessment, and she decided that a lot of kids don't take suicide seriously at Eagle Ridge because we haven't had a crisis like many other high schools have. And in all of our other groups, our focus groups, large survey, and talking to important people, we determined that academics was a huge stressor. This makes sense because we're a college prep school, and we have a lot of academic pressure on the kids, and they probably also receive a lot of pressure from their families. So in our large test, we gave them a few more questions other than just academics. Satisfaction with life. For the most part, our students are pretty satisfied. We have the majority of students rating their satisfaction with life an 8, 9, or a 10, which is pretty positive. Our greatest stressor when we ask them out of academics, personal relationships, financial troubles, or other, most of them said academics or personal relationships, but academics was significantly higher. Our main age range is from the ages 14 to 16, with most kids, about 39 to 40, are 15. As for anyone who's been affected by suicide, most of Eagle Ridge said that they have known someone who's affected by suicide. We didn't ask any specific questions so that we didn't pressure them or ask any direct questions. As for how helpful are the mental health resources at ERA, we got a very large 1 on a scale of 1 to 10. A lot of people rated our scale how helpful the mental resources are as a 1, so we took that into account. ERA causes more problems on average than it's solving problems. So we know a lot of kids at Eagle Ridge are going to be very stressed. And so basically, from our long survey, we deduced that our biggest stressor is academics. When we were conducting the large survey, we passed out around 100 surveys and got a little less than 100, about the same amount. And from that, we could conclude what the majority of students thought at ERA. We have a student body of around 400 students, so we got about 1/4 of our student body. When we got the results back, we tabulated them and we made a few graphs to see the relationships between the answers and the questions. And because of our results, we again deduced that academics are the greatest stressor, that our mental health options are well known, not taken seriously, and not viewed as very helpful. So hopefully with our fire product, we can change that.
The job of our social entrepreneurship is to reduce the academic stress of students.
Our product hopes to unify grades by letting them know about the other grades. This product will also provide interesting perspective into high school life.
We will be creating a blog to measure our social impact where students can give us feedback and can write their own stories to contribute. To combat academic stress, we will be creating a high school survival guide. There's a section for each grade to deal with their stress differently. For freshmen, you're trying to get used to school. Sophomores, many people have emotional distress and self-discovery. Juniors have the most stress in academics and you mature during that year. Seniors are trying to move on. Each grade is divvied up into more sections that are based on the student armor for the Eagle Ridge Warriors, which is our mascot. Helmets is going to talk about grades and academics. Chest plates are about emotional and health problems and how to deal with them. Braces will talk about resources and after-school clubs and activities. Shin guards will be general quirks about the school and what not to do. Boots will talk about the athletic program.
We have a very dynamic fire group at Eagle Ridge Academy. My name is McKenna, and I'm kind of the social butterfly of the group. I'm also involved with drama, so I know a lot about that too.
My name is Alex, and my specific attribute that helps out with fire so much is specifically my age. I'm 18 and a senior, so I've had all the experiences that the other fire kids are just now experiencing. I'll be able to offer a lot of advice in our book, and because of my involvement with student council, we can get it distributed.
Urani is involved in sports, and she's a fun person. She knows everybody and can get the word out quick.
Sarah Stewart is maybe our most valuable person on the team. She is a writer, and she is currently working on a novel to be edited, published, and she's written a bunch more novels. She's very artistic, and she can write like a boss.
Josh is the average Joe. He knows everybody and is a pretty funny guy, so he can help us out a lot.
We have a very diverse fire group. We have a senior, two juniors, a sophomore, and a freshman. With all of us combined, our guide will have experiences from all of us to pass down to the students. So every student from 8th grade to 12th grade will understand experiences of high school and what to expect in their future years to come in their high school career. Our group's biggest advantage is that we are diverse and we have every person from every class in our group. And also, we look inside and pay attention to every detail we can in our product to make sure everything is included in our manual or survival guide for the students to be prepared.
We will operate our social enterprise mainly just by using the Fire Within kids. We'll be the ones getting the word out and probably selling the most books ourselves. I can also work closely with student council to get them sold through our school store as well as other StuCo members. We plan to sell them at the end of the year as kids move up throughout the grades because they're going to need to be prepared for their next grade. We'll also be selling during orientation, and whenever 8th graders come to do shadow dates and visits, we'll try to sell to them as well. Our product will be sustainable after our class because we can add on different versions of the book, update it because of teachers and changes in school dynamics, and we're thinking about even adding on a school survival care package. It can be filled with mini stress relievers, fun things, and practical things like binders, awesome pencils, and highlighters. But that's to be determined next year. Because our survival guide is planned to be a bound book, we're going to be looking at about $10 per book by printing through a professional website. Because it's $10 per book, we'll probably be selling them for around $15 so that we make a pretty substantial profit. If the book ends up being more expensive to make, then we can bring the price up to around $20. If they end up being less, then we can maybe bring it down to 10, but 15 is probably our projected price. Depending on how much seed money we get is going to determine how many books we're able to order. If we have 10 books for $10, that means we'll be spending all the $100 of seed money. To get more money to make more books, it's going to be a steady climb using our profits. If we get the $500 seed money, not only will we be able to print multiple books, a substantial amount of books, we might also be able to develop the care package idea.
So we're going to be marketing at our school through Monday meeting,
morning announcements,
school newspaper,
school webpage,
the TV over our front office,
flyers,
social networking, and that's how we're going to be marketing.
Thanks for
watching.
This
was Eagle Ridge
Academy.
Warriors.
Yeah. Wow. We are Warriors!